Hello dear friends, this is Dr. Diptesh Patel and welcome back to online video lecture series of Jet Propulsion and Aircraft Engineering. This is lecture 10 of Principles of Jet Propulsion. In this video lecture, we are going to solve a numerical for, since the numericals are very important particular for this chapter. So the numerical says here, a ramjet engine operates at Mach number 1.2 at an altitude of 6500 meters. So Mach number at the inlet is given, Z which is the elevation or the altitude, that is given 6500 meters. The diameter of inlet diffuser at entry is 50 centimeters. So the inlet diameter of diffuser is given. The stagnation temperature of the nozzle entry is 1500 Kelvin. So the inlet temperature at the nozzle, but what, the stagnation temperature, so TO3 is given. The calorific value of the fuel, that is 40 megajoule per kilogram, and the velocity of air at the diffuser exit is considered as a negligible. Since the properties of the combustion gases would be taken same as the air, so therefore we need to take the gamma for the combustion gases is equal to 1.4 and characteristic gas constant, that is R, that would be 287 joule per kilogram Kelvin. Also the efficiencies are given to us, and that those efficiency for the diffuser is 0.9, for the combustion chamber or the combustor is 0.98, and the nozzle is 0.96. So these are the different data which are given to us. On the basis of that, we need to calculate these six different things. First one is the efficiency of ideal cycle, so eta R. Second one is a flight speed, so small u. Third one is a air flow rate, means MA. Fourth one is a diffuser pressure ratio, so ROD. Fifth one is a fuel air ratio, so MF upon MA. And the last one is nozzle jet Mach number. So we need to calculate the Mach number at the exit of the nozzles, and that is M4. So these are the six different findings that we need to go through in this numerical. Okay, so let's revise with the given data. Inlet Mach number M1, which is 1.2, elevation or altitude Z is equal to 6500 meter. D1, diameter of diffuser at the inlet, that is 50 centimeter, and we can take is 0.5 meter. Then the stagnation temperature at the inlet of nozzles, that is TO3, 1500 Kelvin. CV, calorific value, 40,000 kilojoule per kilogram, we have converted into the kilojoule. Then efficiency of diffuser 0.9, efficiency of combustor 0.98, and efficiency of nozzle 0.96. So these are the different data which is given to us. These are the findings: eta R, U, MA, ROD, MA upon MF, and M4. So these are the different calculations that we need to make in this numerical. So before we start the example, let's understand the different values. Alright, so basically ramjet engine, it doesn't have a compressor, it doesn't have a turbine. So it is been divided in four different sections. Section 1 to 2 represent the diffuser section. So 1 is the inlet of the diffuser, 2 is the outlet of the diffuser. 2 to 3 is for the combustion chamber or combustion zone. So 2 is the inlet of the combustion chamber, 3 is the outlet of the combustion chamber. And 3 to 4 is a nozzle. So 3 for the inlet of nozzles and 4 is the outlet of the nozzles. M1, which is the air that is entering into the diffuser, a Mach number of air at the inlet. M4, that we need to find out, that is the Mach number of gases which are leaving the nozzles. Also you can see the temperature and the pressure for each section. So P1, T1, then TO2, PO2, stagnation properties, then TO3, PO4, PO3, that is also stagnation properties. Then at the section 4, we need to get T4 and P4. So these are the different values, some of them are given, some that we need to find out. Okay, so let's start the example. First of all, let's start with the ideal efficiency or ideal cycle efficiencies. So that is NR. The equation is 1 divided by 1 plus 2 upon gamma minus 1 into 1 upon m1 square. So since gamma and m1, these values all given, so we just need to replace those values and put them into these equations, and we can find out the efficiency for ideal cycle. So since we have replaced it, the equation would become 1 upon 1 plus 2 divided by 1.4 minus 1 into 1 upon 1.2 square. So after going through the calculations, I could get 0.223, and therefore that would be 22.3%. So that is the ideal efficiency, our first finding. Now let's move forward. From the gas table, at elevation Z, that is 6500, on the basis of that I could get the temperature of the air and the pressure, temperature and density of air at the inlet. So here from the gas table I could get T1 is equal to 245.90 Kelvin, P1 would be at that elevation 0.440 bar. So after conversion we can get 0.440 into 10 raised to 5 Newton per meter square. Then density at the inlet of diffuser, that is 0.624 kilogram per meter cube. And also A1, that is 314.5 meter per second. So let's find out the flight speed. Okay, so since we know that the Mach number at the entry, at the inlet, M1. So M1 is equal to flight speed divided by velocity of sound. We know that this formula, Mach number, which is the ratio of object velocity to the velocity of sound. So therefore M1 is equal to U upon A1. Okay. So since we are going to replace that with the values, Mach number is 1.2 and A1 is 314.5. So let's find out the values of U, which is a flight velocity, that would become 377.4 meter per second. So this is our second finding. Now let's move forward. Area of cross section of the diffuser. So A1, area is equal to pi by 4 D1 square. So therefore pi by 4 D1 square is available. So let's put the values over here, 0.50 meter square. So therefore A1 would become 0.1963 meter square. Then after, air flow rate of the diffuser. So MA, this is our third finding. So MA is equal to rho 1 A1 U. Right? Density at the inlet, area at the inlet, and the speed of the jet. So rho 1 0.624, A1 0.1963, and velocity is 377.4 meter per second. So we can calculate MA is equal to 46.228 kilogram per second. Third finding is done. Now let's move forward to the fourth finding, that is the diffuser efficiency, the diffuser pressure ratio. Now since diffuser efficiency is given to us, we can use it to find out the diffuser pressure ratio, and the equations for the diffuser efficiency, eta d is equal to ROD, that is the diffuser pressure ratio, raised to gamma minus 1 upon gamma minus 1 divided by gamma minus 1 divided by 2 m1 square, right? So now let's put the values. We can get 0.9 for the diffuser efficiency, gamma is given to us 1.4, and the Mach number is 1.2. So after putting those value, I should be able to calculate the diffuser pressure ratio, ROD, that is 2.239. So means the pressure ratio at the outlet of the diffuser to the inlet of the diffuser, or I could say PO2 to P1. So PO2 upon P1 is equal to 2.239. So that is the pressure ratio. Then after, now we are going to use the Mach number relations. So since for the stagnation temperature, TO upon T is equal to 1 plus gamma minus 1 upon 2 m square. Now these are the relations that we have derived in chapter 1. Okay, so for the inlet I could be able to write down TO1 divided by T1 is equal to 1 plus gamma minus 1 upon 2 m1 square. So therefore TO1 is equal to 316.72. all right, so what we have done, we just put the values of T1, temperature 1, which was obtained from the gas table, gamma is given, Mach number is given. So I've just put those value in this equation and I could get the TO1, that is 316.72, and of course the TO1 would be equal to TO2. Okay, so the temperature would be remain constant during these two sections. Then the combustion efficiency of ramjet engine, that is given to us, efficiency of combustion chamber, eta R. So the equation is MACP inside the bracket TO3 minus TO2 divided by MF into CV. Okay, so combustion efficiency is 0.98, that is given to us, mass of air that has been found out 46.228, CP that we are going to take 1005, TO3 that is 1500 minus TO2 316.72 divided by MF that we need to find out, and calorific value is given to us. So we are going to convert that into the joule per kilogram. So that is 40 into 10 raised to 6. And after going through the calculation, I can get mass of fuel that is equal to 1.402 kilogram per second. Now, since I have MA and MF both, I can get the fuel air ratio. So fuel air ratio MF upon MA is equal to 1.402 divided by 46.228, that is equal to 0.0303. So fuel ratio is 0.0303. So that is our fifth finding. Now let's move forward. Since we got P4 upon PO3, which is also equal to P1 upon PO2. O, that simply represents the stagnation conditions, and that is equal to 1 divided by 2.239. So therefore the ratio would become 0.446. Also, for the combustion chamber, the combustion takes place at the constant pressure. So since we know that the inlet of the combustion chamber and outlet of the combustion chamber would be equal, so therefore I should be able to write down PO3 is equal to PO2. Also, for the complete expansion in nozzles, the P4, that is the outlet of the nozzle, that's supposed to be equal to the inlet of the air, the pressure at the inlet of the diffuser. So therefore P4 is equal to P1. So from isentropic relations, which can be obtained, gamma that is equal to 1.4, and the P4 divided by PO3, that is the ratio of P4 divided by PO3, that we have got 0.446, I could get PM4S, that is equal to 1.14. okay, that is the Mach number at the 4 isentropic. Now T4S divided by TO4, that is equal to 0.794, and since we are going to use the gas table over here, and that was available in the book, so from that I could get T4S, that is equal to 0.794 into TO4, right? So that would be equal to 0.794 into 1500, since the temperature at the inlet of the nozzles, that is given to us, and that temperature is 1500 Kelvin. And since we know that the temperature during the nozzles or flow during the inside the nozzle would be constant, so therefore TO3 is equal to TO4, so we are going to take 1500 straight away, and there on the basis of that I could be able to calculate T4S, that is 1191 Kelvin. Okay, now nozzle efficiency, that is given to us. So nozzle efficiency is given to us, that is 0.96. I'm going to use that equation and going to find out the values of the temperature at the outlet of the nozzles. So nozzle efficiency eta n is equal to TO4 minus T4 divided by TO4 minus T4S. So just put the values over here, 0.96, which is equal to 1500 minus T4 divided by 1500 minus 1191. Okay, so After going through the calculations, I would get T4 is equal to 1203.36 Kelvin. Then move forward to the stagnation temperature. TO, which is equal to T plus C square divided by 2Cp. That is the formula to calculate the stagnation temperature. And on the those for on that formula, I should be able to write down TO4 is equal to T4 plus C4 square divided by 2Cp. So let's just put the values here. TO4, that is 1500, T4 that we just found out 1203.36 plus C4 square that we need to find out in for these equations, divide by 2 into 1005. So let's get the values of C4 square, and that is 596.24 into 10 raised to 3, and that would be the exit velocity C4 would be 772.16 meter per second. So that is the exit velocity. Now on the basis of that exit velocity, I'm going to find out the Mach number, but I need the sound velocity at the exit too. So let's calculate the sound velocity at exit. Velocity of sound at the exit A4, which is equal to under root of gamma r T4, since we know that A is equal to under root of gamma r T. So gamma 1.4, r 287, and T4 1203.36 that we have obtained. So on the basis of that, I should be able to calculate A4, that is the velocity of sound at the exit. So that would be 695.35 meter per second. And now it's time to calculate the Mach number at the exit of the nozzle. So M4 is equal to C4 divided by A4, right? So C4 that has been calculated 772.16, and A4 that is equal to 695.35. So going through the calculations, I should get M4 is equal to 1.110. So that is the Mach number at exit. Okay. So this is all at the moment. If you have any doubt, you can write down in the comment box. Thank you.